Good evening. It's my great privilege to be here and introduce one of the most renowned speaker, Mr. Vijay Batra. Mr. Vijay Batra is not a new name for AMA. As he just said, last year he was also here. And as I said, it's a proud privilege to be with him and to introduce. Look, Mr. Vijay Batra is a very unique blend of corporate success from three entirely different countries, India, Japan, and America. Countries which are far off, countries which are very unique in their own manner, at the same time, countries which have a lot of commonalities. Mr. Batra has worked for a long years in all of the three countries, and that brings, that lineage brings him this wealth of this information, leading to corporate success. He's embodied now what is called a principle of samurai, and he's one of the unique speaker who conducts sensitization programs for corporates and society in general for people. For Indian who want to go to Japan, who want to deal with the Japanese people, who want to do business with Japan, as also the people in Japan who want to work with India, who want to get success in India, am I right? He's one of the unique speaker. And I must say that it's so relevant, so topical for Ahmedabad Management Association, for all of us. As you might know, Mr. Batra, only maybe less than one month back, at AMA, we had inaugurated a special center where India and Japan are going to collaborate in a big manner. In fact, the Consulate General of Japan was here in this very auditorium on the inaugural function. And India and Japan are going to collaborate in the mainly in the field of cultural field, and later on it will be corporate field also. And AMA and Japan has collaborated. So a person with Mr. Batra's experience and exposure in Japan coming at this particular time adds to the value of what AMA is trying to do. His book, you must have seen the book outside, which is available to people who are interested in purchasing it. That book, and he's going to have the philosophy of the book, and I think today's talk. That book has a very unique concept called what is called water tap philosophy. What does it say? It says that a company or a corporate is not of or only for the owners, or maybe the collective shareholders. It is meant to be for the society, society at large, stakeholders at large. Why? Because it says that profit is something which society gives back to the company. It's a very unique concept. It says that a company should produce in such a manner, a corporate should behave in such a manner, to produce in such a mass manner, the products which otherwise a common man cannot afford. And just like we can afford a tap water. What is tap water? Then our Gujarati am kahi na nalnu pani. Just like we can afford a tap water, a company or a corporate should also produce in such a manner, in such a quantum, that everybody in a society can afford it. It's a so unique a concept, and that concept also incorporates, it's not a charity actually. Okay, we are not going about charity here. It doesn't mean that corporate should not make profit, but the profitability is such nature wherein society gets benefit. The book also advocates the spirit of competitiveness. You must recognize competitors who are healthy, who are good enough, and then only you can go ahead. So in all, it's advocating the art of positive thinking. It's the art of positive thinking and work ethics. I think that's what the philosophy is all around. And it's a very unique blend, as I said. And we are fortunate that he is here. And before he starts his own speech, I would like to welcome him on behalf of AMA as well as on all of us with a bouquet of flower.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome. It's indeed an honor and a privilege for me to be standing here in AMA. The great likes of C.K. Pallaji and Abdul Kalam actually very often are invited by AMA. And for me to be here, is a very humbling experience, because you know, by no means am I even close to these people. But it's a privilege for me to come here. I must compliment AMA, Mr. Butch, and especially Mr. K.K. Nair. Mr. K.K. Nair actually has been a source of inspiration for me for many, many years. He and my father have known each other. And whenever I come to Ahmedabad, especially AMA, my father is very, very happy that I'm going to meet a Karam Yogi. I'm sure all of you know Mr. K.K. Nair fairly well. And I basically am based in Delhi right now. And DMA, unfortunately, is very, very small, very inactive compared to AMA. Why? Because of K.K. Nair. Obviously, today's talk is not on K.K. Nair, it's on Matsushita Konosuke. But I think if you really want to see a human version of Matsushita Konosuke in India, I think you may want to go and shake hands with K.K. Nair. It's right here, right here. You know, I've known him for the past few years. In fact, I started my speaking career in 1997 in AMA. And in fact, my father had brought me along. And at that time, I was keen to become a speaker, but I was very nervous. Mujhe dar lagta tha logon ke samne baat karne mein. So I remember Mr. K.K. Nair was very, very nice. He said, why don't you come and talk to some of the people who may want to learn about what Japanese are doing? Because at that time, I was working for a Japanese company and I'd come back to India. So in fact, in one of the classes, you know, which you must have passed coming here, is where I started my speaking career. And it's been almost 16 years and I've never looked back. So I have a lot of regard for AMA. My name is Vijay Michihito Batra, because my mother was Japanese, my father's an Indian. And they both met in America. They had gone to study. My father had gone from India in the late 50s and my mother had come from Japan. And it's been a privilege for me to be, living in America, Japan, and India. And now it's becoming a global village, right? And it doesn't make a difference where you're born, I guess. The world is open to you. And although I'm half Japanese and half Indian, I think my heart is very much more towards India, although I have a lot of regard. Towards the Japanese for what they've done, but dil hai Hindustani. And it's very good that if any one state in India that can come close to being Japan is Gujarat. And I think it's always a privilege for anybody from any part of the country to come to Gujarat, because here we see that things are possible. India can become better. And without being towards BJP, I also hope that Narendra Modi ji will become the Prime Minister next year. You know. I'm apolitical, you know. It's not that I support BJP or Congress. I'm sure if Modi sir were to be in Congress, I'm sure he still probably would deserve to be the Prime Minister. Matsushita Konosuke was an amazing man. I think he's a testimony to the fact that it's not what you are, but what you want to become that makes all the difference. It's not what you are, but what you want to become that makes all the difference. You know, Rahul Gandhi obviously is born into a great family, but unless he wants to become greater, you know, being born into the greatest family in the country doesn't make you any better. Whereas I'm sure Narendra Modi's family was not known to many people, you know, before, you know, he started his journey towards becoming better and better. And Matsushita Konosuke actually chronicles that. So is Dhirubhai Ambani. You know, Dhirubhai Ambani is also the Indian version of Matsushita Konosuke. Except if you were to compare Dhirubhai Ambani and Matsushita Konosuke, maybe Matsushita Konosuke was a little bit more ethical than Dhirubhai Ambani. But you know, you can't help it, because Dhirubhai Ambani was growing in a country which was very, very difficult to be ethical and to grow, I guess. Whereas Japan, relatively, I think, was not as corrupt, although Japan is also corrupt. But I think Matsushita Konosuke is a man who only had 6 years of formal education. Imagine. Chhati ke baad padhai nahi ki unhe, kyunki his father had made some blunders. His father was into speculation, like many Gujaratis are at times, is it not, right? And sometimes you lose your control, and he lost everything that he had owned. And at a very tender age of 9 years old, Matsushita Konosuke had to start to work as a domestic servant. And on top of that, imagine, because at that time Japan was also a struggling country, working as a domestic servant Wherever he was working, they were not giving him enough food, quality food. So because of malnutrition, when he grew up, he had a lot of bronchital issues, acute bronchital issues because of malnutrition and having to work in very adverse conditions. So he could not actually hold on to a job for more than a few weeks because people would fire him, because he could not work non-stop, because very often he would have an asthma attack and he could not go to work. So then he, you know, thought to himself, what do I do? I can't hold on to a job because people fire me because I take holidays. So then he said, okay, fine, let me become an entrepreneur. And he became an entrepreneur. And he said, the days when I'm healthy, I'll work very, very hard, as much as I can. And the days when I'm not in a position to work, I'll not work. And he started his company by his own name, Matsushita Electric Industries. And it was started by he, his wife, and his brother-in-law, yani ki Saleh Saab, biwi ke jo bhai hote hain. And that brother-in-law went on to create his own entity, which is also very, very popular, called Sharp Industries. So Sharp ke jija ji hain Matsushita, so you can imagine, right? It's a big company. Now, I would like to, you know, take you through a journey. Matsushita Konosuke actually borrowed a lot from the Japanese samurai spirit. As you know, samurais in Japan were the warriors. But if you were to look into the meaning of the word samurai does not mean to kill. The word samurai means to serve. If you've seen the movie The Last Samurai, I don't know if anyone has seen that movie Last Samurai, I would suggest ki aap is picture ko zarur dekhiyega, The Last Samurai. It has Tom Cruise, but it doesn't have any of the glamour element, but it has a lot of learning. And I would like to start the session with a brief clip from the movie The Last Samurai that introduces Japan. So Matsushita Konosuke definitely gives a lot of credit to his philosophy and his success to the Japanese philosophy, the Japanese way of life. And similarly, I guess many Indian entrepreneurs, if they were to live the Indian philosophy, I'm sure they would also do very, very well, because Indian philosophy is also very, very powerful and very, very deep. But very few people obviously are living that philosophy. Matsushita Konosuke lived the Japanese philosophy. And when you see this brief video, I think it'll get you into the mood of Matsushita.
They say Japan was made by a sword. They say the old gods tipped a coral blade into the ocean, and when they pulled it out, four perfect drops fell back into the sea, and those drops became the islands of Japan. I say Japan was made by a handful of brave men. Warriors willing to give their lives for what seems to have become a forgotten word. Honor.
Now for a samurai, I think it's very, very important for him or her to live an honorable life. And so is the case for a business person. The moment a businessman or a woman does something which is not honorable, then he or she is no longer a businessman, right? Or a woman. He or she becomes a con artist. It's very, very important for a business person to ensure that whatever he or she is promising to the stakeholders, customers or vendors or anybody else or employees, he or she will do everything he or she can to fulfill those commitments. And Matsushita lived by that code, that I would honor my commitments at any cost. Yes, on occasions he may not be able to meet his commitments on a certain timeline, but the reason why he succeeded was because he ultimately fulfilled on his commitments. And I think we Indians also need to learn that. Chuna lagana, topi ghumana, you know, all these things actually would not work. Is it not? If you really want to be a businessman or a businesswoman, and one thing when you learn about Matsushita Konosuke, you realize very, very sharply, ki sirf paisa kamana ye is not business. You've got to add value. to somebody else. If you're not adding value to somebody else, you're just basically in a casino, just making money. It's very, very important for any person who wants to be a business person to add value. Even if you're a stockbroker and you have your stock brokerage company, the value that you earn, add, is liquidity to the market. That's okay. Everybody has to be very, very clear ki agar main koi dhanda kar raha hoon, I've got to add value. But that's a sad part very often you and I as business people miss totally. Hame lagta hai sirf munafa hi kamana hai. Munafa bhi kamana hai. Matsushita Konosuke, imagine, he only had 6 years of education. He didn't go to an equivalent of IIM in Japan. Yet, he was being referred to as a god of management. God of? What do we understand from this? That life teaches you many things if you are willing to learn, is it not? But here in Hindustan, today, some people don't want to learn. They wear a pukhraj moga. निर्मल बाबा के दरबार में पहुंच जाते हैं, काले कुत्ते को बाजरे की रोटी खिलाना शुरू कर देते हैं. यू नो इट्स सो सैड इन अ कंट्री विच इज ऑब्वियसली बीन गिवन सच ग्रेट फिलोसफीज लाइक द महाभारत, जहाँ पे कर्म पे फोकस किया गया है, उस देश में हम ऐसी चीजें कर रहे हैं विच हैज ऑब्वियसली नो एक्सप्लेनेशन. क्यों? इन जापान नोबडी विशेज ईच अदर बेस्ट ऑफ लक. दे ऑलवेज से डू योर बेस्ट. दिस देश में सावित्री जैसे का लेख है कि शी वॉज एबल टू टेक द हस्बैंड बैक फ्रॉम यमराज. यू नो व्हाई आर वी यूजिंग सर्टन प्रैक्टिसेस दैट आर सपोज टू मेक अस लकी. मतलब गुजरात का नहीं मुझे पता, पर दिल्ली का मैं बता सकता हूं कि यहां कई लोग हैं कि शनि से भागते हैं, सरसों के तेल में चवन्नियां डालते हैं. यू थिंक डालने से शनि भगवान आपका नाम उस लिस्ट से काट देगा? नाउ दिस ईयर वी आर सेलिब्रेटिंग द 150th एनिवर्सरी ऑफ स्वामी विवेकानंद, राइट? स्वामी विवेकानंद सेड कि जो खुद पे विश्वास ना करे वो इंसान नास्तिक है. यू गॉट टू बिलीव इन योर सेल्फ. एंड इन फैक्ट इफ यू वर टू सी मात्सुकिता फिलोसफी इज वेरी क्लोज टू वॉट विवेकानंद जी और भगवद गीता और फॉर दैट मैटर इवन रामायण बेसिकली वुड बी देयर टू टीच अस. देयर इज नॉट मच ऑफ अ डिफरेंस. द ओनली थिंग इज द वे ऑब्वियसली द प्रैक्टिस इट इज मे बी स्लाइटली डिफरेंट. इन फैक्ट इंस्टेड ऑफ विशिंग अवे चैलेंजिंग टाइम्स वी शुड बी विशिंग फॉर बिकमिंग बेटर व्हेन वी फेस चैलेंजेस, इज इट नॉट? यस और नो? हम धंधा शुरू करते हैं और गणेश भगवान के आगे अगरबत्ती अगर जलाते हैं तो उनसे ये आराधना करें कि जब कोई चुनौती आए मुझे इस चुनौती का सामना करने का बल दीजिए, ना कि चुनौती आए ना. क्यों जी? तो चुनौती नहीं आएगी तो आप क्या करोगे? बस हमें मुनाफा चाहिए. तो मुनाफा लेके क्या करोगे? ठीक है, एक आधा साल तो अच्छा लगता है, उसके बाद क्या करोगे? नाउ रिसेंटली आई एम श्योर इन अहमदाबाद यू मस्ट हैव नोन आई वाज बीइंग